Do we
mother was a prostitute, even though here there was no dishonor surrounding his background, Jephthah didn't want his mother's lifestyle to be questioned, and he didn't want people to look at him because of his mother's lifestyle. Against all odds, he worked hard to try to make a mark and become a respectable individual, someone that people would look up to, and someone that he wouldn't have to answer for what somebody else had done. Jephthah grew to become, the Bible said, a mighty warrior. To be a mighty warrior meant that he was a man of honor. In that day, that's what they call that. Jephthah's brother, born from another woman, was not ready to give him any kind of honor because of his mother. The victories and the exploring walk through Jephthah while he was on the battlefield meant nothing to his brother, even though he had accomplished a lot of things. Through Jephthah didn't choose, nor was responsible for his parents. His half-brother looked down at him because of that situation, and he treated him like he was an individual member of his family because he was the son of a prostitute. They didn't give him any share of the family's inheritance. They made life so unbearable for him that he had to run away from his father's house. Tables aren't fixed. Situation in life aren't fixed. Tables can turn around and in any way. And I want you to know, situations can and will change if you will allow them to do that. Only God is unchanging. He is the unchanging challenger, the one that doesn't change, but yet he changes people's life and people's situation. So if you're here this morning and somebody's told you that you're never going to change, I've got good news for you. There's a man above by the name of Jesus Christ that will give you what you need in your life to change it around. Jephthah, for years, had been oppressed by his brother, how he treated him like rubbish. But the day God turned the table around, the same people that drove him away were the one desperately looking for Jephthah. In Judges chapter 11, the elders of the Gilead exclusive, their brothers was in a fix. You see, it doesn't matter what people go through with when we need them. Don't matter what kind of reputation they got when we need them. Amen. It only matters when we're trying to help ourselves look better. They were faced with enemies stronger than the enemies. They had no clue on how to defeat them. The Ammonites had come against them, and they needed someone to help them lead in the battle. They wanted somebody that could conquer. Sometime later, when the Ammonites made war on the Israel, the elders of Gilead went to Jephthah from the land of Tob. He said, "Come," they said, "to be our commander. We want you to work and be our commander." See, it didn't matter now that his mother was a prostitute. But I want to tell you, God has a way of turning things around. Sometimes when you feel like there's no hope, there's nothing I can do, I'm going to fail in spite of it all, I want you to know that's a lie from hell. You can change your life around. You can become a brand new creature in the Lord Jesus Christ. And it can start right here, right now.
Amen.
Judges chapter 11. The elders of Gilead, exclusive of Jephthah's brother, were in a fix. The elders of Gilead said to him, "Nevertheless, we are turning to you now. We know that you have the answer to all of our problems. Come with us to fight the Ammonites, and we'll make you head over all who lives in Gilead. Can you find traces of yourself in Jephthah's story? Does people look down on you? Have they looked down on you before? Because maybe you wasn't from the high part of society. You know, I watched. God help me not say anything, because you might have been yard of the month. I don't know. But I watched this sign go up in people's yard. Yard of the month. And the one right below them would be a lot prettier than theirs was. But they wasn't in the clique.
Yeah, amen.
You better say amen or oh me, and you better smile or I'll think you're guilty. They wasn't in the clique. Because they wasn't in the clique, they didn't get to be yard of the month. And I'm just using that as an example. But I want to tell you something. When it comes to God, there is no cliques.
Amen.
That's right. There's nobody bigger than nobody else in the church.
Right.
Have you ever been sidelined because you don't have a large following? Are you suggesting or requesting and advocating, usually ignored because you don't attend any certain school, or you don't go to a certain church, or you don't belong to a personal clique or a society standing? You're treated with dismay because of some health or challenges you have. You've been struggling because you don't have a job and you have children. You're not married. People look down at you. Well, I want to tell you something. That's not the way God looks at it. He loves every one of you. And if you believe it, lift your hand and praise Him this morning. I pray today that you will encounter the God who can turn the tables around and make the rejected celebrate and despise the honor, the unvalued, and the high respected, that you can be appreciated.
Yes.
When God turns the table around to favor you, your background becomes unimportant. A complete immature aspect of your life. My dad wasn't a drunk, but if he was, doesn't mean I'm going to be a drunk.
Amen.
My mother wasn't a harlot, but if she was, doesn't mean that I'm going to be a harlot.
Amen.
I don't have a brother, but if I had a brother that was a dope head, doesn't mean I'm going to be a dope head.
Amen.
And I'm tired of these people that looks down on these people that say, oh, they wasn't raised right. That's why they act the way they do. No, that's not the problem. It's sin. And sin is caused by the devil. And you can't put the blame on anything and anybody but the devil.
Amen.
You don't have to sit down, though, in your pity because your parents are rich. Some of you may be sitting back there tonight or this morning and feeling, well, I'm going to get a big inheritance. Well, I ain't. My mother and daddy lived on the mill hill. Brother Baby, we didn't have a lot on the mill hill. We didn't drive the nicest cars. We bought my school clothes from the dollar store. They didn't get them from J.C. Penney's, and they certainly wasn't brand name.
Amen.
I never got to wear a pair of Nike shoes that costed $150 till I got grown and was able to buy it for myself. My daddy worked every day, Dolphin Culver, and then he left and went to Tooney Blacks and run a service station. He gave us a good home. He gave us something to eat. He supplied our needs. But I want to tell you something today. He gave us something far greater than money. He gave us something far greater than riches. He showed me that there was a man named Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, that was able to take care of all my needs. And He's done just that.
Amen.
turns the table around to favor Jephthah, no one remembered that he was the son of a prostitute. People didn't mind having him as their leader, even though he had a marred background. Your background is not an issue to God, so quit allowing people to make an issue with you. You might have been a rotten person. You might have been a person that would steal, lie, cheat, do anything. There's some peoples in the Word of God that I wouldn't have traded nickels with, because if you did, you'd have come up 4 cents short, because they were crooked in the Bible. I'm talking about somebody even Jesus from the James dealt with. They were off the board. They didn't know. And see, we kind of look at ourselves and say, we come from the good side of town. That's rotten. I'm here to tell you, we all sin and come short of the glory of God, and we all had to be forgiven by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't care what you've done. God can turn the tables around. He can make you a brand new creature in the Lord. You lift your hand up and praise Him today. You know, some folks don't even want people coming to church if they've been in jail. I've been in jail to visit. But I'll tell you, don't ever shun anybody.
Amen.
Because right. God may use you
right.
to win them
Amen.
To the Lord. Anyone, respective of the person's background, can become a recipient of God's mercy, of His favor, and of His grace. You don't have to sit down in pity because your parents aren't rich. You don't have to have a godfather in high places. And it appears like that all your peers have gone ahead of you, and it seems like sometimes everybody gets ahead. How many of you have time to, I don't want you to raise your hand, but how many times have you ever said, they got a new car, why can't I have one? They got a new house, why can't I have one? You know, we live in an age where everybody wants to keep up with the Smiths. Just cause they got, let me tell you something else they got. They got a high car payment every month.
Amen.
If they got a new house, they got another car payment. And usually that car payment lasts for 6, 5, 6, and 7 years. Why people finance cars 7 years, I'll never understand. But like, they're wore out 7 years.
Amen.
And if they got a house, hold on, 30 years. Ooh, count that up on your fingers and toes. That's a long time. And you're envying them. Hey, I don't envy them, because I don't want those car payments. I don't want those house payments. I want to pay my tithe, and I want to live for the Lord, and God will take care of my needs. And He will yours, too, if you just let Him. God can turn the tables around. You're going to experience a change, and the pursuer is becoming the highly sought after, because you're allowing God to take care of you. When God turns the table around for Jephthah, the people were on the, came looking for him, and even though he was at home, a dwelling place from idle people, indentured people, and poor people, divine success is not based on physically location of where you live.
Amen.
Look at the Skinners. They live way out that road, way back in the woods. Ain't many people close to you, are you? But they don't feel pity. They're happy
Amen.
To be where they are.
Yeah.
the blackberries, whiteberries. You have to go and go in. They've got a driveway out front. You've got to call them to get in. Unless you knock the door down. That's right. But they're happy.
Amen.
Listen. Most of us will never live in $1 million houses.
Amen.
Who wants to? Brother David, if I lived in $1 million house, you know what I'd do? I'd set it. And I'd take that money and I'd go to Outback Steakhouse tonight. What you live, where you live, not gonna make you happy. What you drive. I see Sister Joanne, she's 23. That convertible Mustang she's got. You know, one time I decided I wanted a convertible and I bought a PT Cruiser. Couldn't leave it down. It blowed my hair too bad. Decided I don't want this thing. Sister Lana said, well, I like it. I said, well, you can have it. I ain't riding it. She said, get rid of it. Because she don't like to drive no way. You and I need to understand, no matter what we're going through, no matter how serious it may seem to us, God can turn the table around.
Amen.
I don't care how sick you are. I don't care what the devil told you to do. He'll tell you to kill yourself. Do you know somebody that commits suicide is a very selfish individual?
Right.
You say, preacher, why do you say that? They're not getting out of anything. They're just getting into something. And they don't realize it. You and I need to know, no matter what our situation is, no matter what we're going through, you may say, I'm trying. We're going to do the best we can. If you do the best you can, God will make a way for you to do more than you've ever done before. He will turn the table around for you, just like he done Jephthah.
Amen.
With every head bowed, every eye closed, I've got to stop. I want to ask a question this morning. I just feel led. Now's the time. Saints of God, lift your hands. Praise the Lord. Right here. Right now.
Lord, if somebody that peace of their hearts and lives is able to lay, God, take your hand, hold us, and make us
feel
for you, Lord. Take us, and Lord, not come amongst us. Help
us. Feel.
Help us, say, Lord, not my mind.
Right now.
Lord, not my will, but your will be done. Blessing or anything, God. Let your will be done.
And you're going through. That
we can almost look up and know
and you need God.
Praise you, Lord.
Oh, he's in this house to turn the tables for you. Saints of God, get your mind on the Lord.
Yes, God, help
me. Ina ba 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 shatana ba kaya talia. the table right now with no one looking around but me and the Lord. I want you to raise your hand in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Better yet, I feel led. If you want God to turn the table in your life, stand to your feet right now. In the name of Jesus, get to your feet right now. There's others. There's at least 8 to 10 folks in this building that you can be on your feet right now because you know God's got to do something to change something that you're dealing with. You that are standing, and others will join in. I want you to make your way to this altar right now. Holy Ghost, move in this place. If you want to change, I want you to come right now. If you don't want to come, that's okay. That's between you and God. But I'm doing this the way God told me to do it. If you want God to turn things around for you, I want you to come. I want you to come. There's more kneeling this altar. There's some more here. There's some ladies. There's some men. There's some young folks. You need God to do something for you right now. You need God to turn around some things that you're going through. Will you just stand to your feet in the name of Jesus? In the name of Jesus. I want every man and woman, boy and girl, in this building that you know you're a Christian. I need you in this altar right now. Thank you. Come on. Right now. Come on. In the name of Jesus. Come on. If you're a child of God, I need you here. Come on. Somebody needs you to pray with them. Praise God. Somebody needs you. Come on. In the name of Jesus. Come on, that's right. Oh, God help us. Come on, brother. Get in here with these brothers. Oh, hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Jesus is Lord.
Oh, hallelujah. you is our prayer. Remember, no matter what you're going through, God can turn it around. No matter what it is, He can turn it around. The Lord's good. He's always been good to me. I love the church of God because it's been good to me through the Lord. I want to thank you, Brother Jerry, for sweeping the church yard. I guess you did that. We went out, I think it was on Monday, I called you. And we went out Tuesday morning. There was green leaves everywhere. Well, you saw it. It was everywhere. When I got in the car and backed up, I have to tell them, Sister Wallace, got going out back to the driveway. She said, "Man." I said, "What?" She said, "The wind must have really blown last night." I said, "Why you say that?" She said, "This parking lot was filled with green leaves." I said, "Honey, you reckon Brother Jerry came and swept it with that tractor?" She said, "Oh." I didn't think about that. God's good, isn't He? He's good. You know, we've had, I seen a lot of trees down. Had trees fall even on my property and turn my fence down. But I'm thankful. We didn't have nothing like Florida or Houston. We didn't have nothing like that. And I'm thankful for that. Keep praying for these folks in your prayer. Keep praying for Maddie and their family. They got the brother in the hospital. Their sister's in the hospital. And I guess it's your niece is in the hospital. Brother Junior said everybody's going to the hospital. So hope and pray that they won't go to the hospital. Right. Be praying for them. And be praying for Keith Skinner. Before I kill him. To get a place, get him a job where he can be here on Sunday. And I want to say one thing, I'm going to be saying it again. I'm going to go ahead and say it now. If you're a teacher, and I hope these that are out today will listen to what I got to say, because I'll say it to them too. If you're a teacher, you have an obligation to be here if you're not working. Brother Bobby's number is in the bulletin. So that's not an excuse. So some can quit using that for an excuse. It's in the bulletin. You know if you're going to be sick, at least the day, that night before you go to bed. Please don't wait. I'm getting calls at 8, 9, 9:30. We ain't going to get to be there. We're sick. If you do that on your job a couple of times, they'll fire you. I'm not firing anybody. You don't ever get fired in the Church of God. You get a job for a lot, you get it for life. But let's be a little bit more considerate, because teaching Sunday school is important.
Amen.
It's very important. People don't just come to hear anybody, they come to hear you. But please, if you're going to be sick, whatever, give him a notice, because it's hard to run around here in the morning and try to combine classes with teachers. And there's some of you out there who could teach, you just aren't doing it.
Amen.
And I wish you'd pray about it and ask the Lord, if He wants you to do it, do it. It would help the church out tremendous. We do all we can. There's some places we're stretched very thin. So if you decide you'd like to help teach a class, I don't know if I can give you the class you want, but I can give you a class. But if you can help, please see me about it or Bobby about it, and we'll see you get a job and go to work. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen.
Don't forget the ladies' meeting. Come up to the choir, please. Lord, as we come to you again, God, we love you, appreciate you, and we thank you, God, for this good service we had today. Thank you, Lord, for this good message, Lord, that you sent our pastor, Lord. God, we pray, Lord, that you help us, Lord, to take it and apply it to our lives, Lord Jesus. God, we love you and we appreciate you. We thank you, God, for everything you do for us, God. Thank you for everyone who come this way, Lord. And we pray, God, that you will keep your mighty hand upon them as they go to their homes. And we'll give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen.